Check your office door.
Homicide, come in, this is dispatch. Hey, there's a call for you guys down at Church of St. Vincent de Paul. Uniforms are already on scene. This is a weird one.
Confession.
family home yesterday at dusk. Her father was severely opposed to our presence. He wouldn't let me nor my guide step foot in his home. And though we tried to convince him otherwise, we eventually chose to abide his wishes and prepare for a night on the streets outside their home. We sat below her window. Just above our heads, we could hear her strained cries through the night. The hours drew on. We tried to reason with her father again, but he was as stubborn as I persisted. We all raised our voices. She must have heard us as we argued in the street below, because she let out a scream with such ferocity that I thought a pack of wild dogs must be in her room. We raced upstairs. I was right behind her father as he flung open the door. The sight inside was like nothing I've seen before. A broken young girl. A body twisted and fractured, devoid of life, innocence, and soul.
Thank you. Detective, a package arrived for you. It's on your desk.
see you, detective. Some new toys.
Thank you.
Detective, a package arrived for you. It's on your desk. Yeah, you're welcome.
It's 2 a.m. I was asleep on the couch, and I could hear her again. Listen. Did you hear that? Listen. I thought I was hearing things at first, but it happens every night now. Is that a voice?
Oh, dear. Have you been left all alone? There, my precious.
What the hell is it? Who is it? Nice to meet you, Detective. I'm a little freaked out. The nursery's upstairs.
Thank you. Won't you come down?
Can't take these pills. What about our baby? I took what was mine. He is with me.
I'm horrified.
I hope you like the flowers.
They're wild.
This is a private party, Maria. Don't let him in.
Why not the door lock? I don't.
Are you crying, Yarp?
He wants what's inside me.
Hold on, honey. Just hold on. God, no. God, no. God, no. I need an ambulance now. Please. Oh, my boy. She hurt herself. She's pregnant. Please, come to my room.
you so much, Detective. It's... means more to me than I can say. It's all that I have now.
Detective, a package arrived for you. It's on your desk.
Check your office board. Thank you.
battery low. Please dock to charge.
To me.
Detective, a package arrived for you. It's on your desk. Yeah, you're welcome.
Detective Jameson, prisoner interview at New Hampshire CF.
Where's the detective? I want Boston PD.
You're in New Hampshire, pal. We ain't going on a field trip. I'm all you got. So you can tell me what you need.
You're wasting time. I can feel Pazuzu clouding my mind.
Pazuzu? Screw this. Guard!
No, wait. I'll talk, okay? You have to promise you'll get this to Boston PD.
Just get on with it, pal.
Detective, I hope you're listening because he is listening. He hears everything and has silenced all that oppose him. I know that he wants me next. But be warned, Detective. I'm not his prize. You are.
This is going nowhere.
You must go to his tomb. It's the only way. It sits sealed off below the border of Iraq and Jordan. Someone must have disturbed the excavation site. Please,
enough. We're through here. I've got real work to do, you whack job. Detective Jameson, prisoner interview at New Hampshire CF. Look, pal, you gonna confess today, or is this another waste of time?
Confession? Yes. I do have a confession to make. I torture men for our own gain. I take their eyes to see. I take their tongue to speak. And I take their souls to feed.
Okay, so who have you tortured? Give me a list.
Oh, many, many. Too many to count. You think me a copycat. You think me obsessed with a Gemini killer. You call me copycat killer, but I am not. I am the original. I am the madness in the caves of Decapolis. And wild dogs loose on the girl in Morocco. I am the claw in that priest's throat. I am the noose upon this man's neck. I am the voice in your head.
Check your office, boy. Thank you.
Do you like chasing the dead, detective?
Thank you. This is Father Phineas Bell of St. Vincent de Paul in Boston. If you're listening to this, I expect that Pazuzu has already stained my mind. Do not let him do the same to you. You must finish my work. However lucid his savage visions, however piercing his violent threats, he must be stopped. His flame must be extinguished and his presence expelled from the tomb. It is the only way. It is the only way.
Thank you. Which god it is?
Copy?
Good morning, Detective. Glad to see you are recovering fast. I just left your notes as requested. Now rest, you will be needed back on duty soon.